Are qualia fields and quantum fields complementary to each other? Are they entangled? So I'm glad to announce that quantum body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life, co-authored with Jack Tuzinski, quantum biologist and quantum scientist, and Brian Fertig, fellow endocrinologist. So today I'm asking and raising the question, are quantum fields and qualia fields connected? So as we know, quantum fluctuations are expressions of the quantum field, and qualia are the subjective qualitative experience that we have as humans, which include sensations, sense perceptions, feelings, images, and thoughts. Quantum fields are the underlying fields of energy that are thought to make up the universe. They are responsible for the forces of nature, such as electromagnetism and gravity. Quantum fields are also inherently probabilistic, meaning they can exist in multiple states simultaneously. So, some scientists and some philosophers have proposed that qualia and quanta may be complementarities, which means they are entangled. And there is some evidence to support this idea. For example, some experiments have shown that the behavior of quantum fields can be influenced by consciousness. Additionally, the probabilistic nature of quantum fields seems to mirror the subjective nature of qualia. And this is something that is being discussed right now, and many consciousness experts are proposing something called panpsychism, which I do not subscribe to, because panpsychism assumes the existence of matter, and I believe matter is the human word for a combination of sensations like hardness, solidity, borders, space-time, location, units of mass and energy, but it's still a model of a more fundamental reality, which is perceptual activity in our consciousness. So let's say that qualia are fluctuations of the consciousness field, and let's say quanta are fluctuations of the quantum field. So qualia of the consciousness field, quanta of the quantum field or elementary particles. And they're very similar, at least the analogies are similar. Everything that we call a particle exists in superposition with all other particles until it is observed, and then you see the appearance of a particle. Similarly, all our thoughts and emotions and feelings are in superposition until one manifests. And there are other analogies, probabilistic nature, indeterminacy, the fact that you have to do an experiment to observe a particle, in other words, you have to measure it, and the fact that attention and intention localizes awareness of the consciousness field, all very similar. So, what relationship does this have to quantum body? And I think the relationship is your body can be understood physically as the expression of the quantum field. But as an experience, it can be understood as an expression of the qualia field, as an experience. We experience not quanta, but sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts. So let's say they're both correlated and entangled. And then we have this idea of samadhi. Samadhi means absence of subject-object split, when the observer and the observed become one. Okay, samadhi. So if samadhi is resolution of the observer-observed split and is fundamental reality, here quantum fields and qualia fields become one. And as we achieve samadhi through meditation and mindful awareness and many techniques, breath awareness, and basically understanding that the subject-object split is artificial, as we get to the state of samadhi, it seems reasonable that the arrow of time should no longer apply, because time is entropy, and entropy is a result of generation and loss of heat. But in samadhi, entropy is minimal, okay, or reduced dramatically. Metabolic rates is reduced dramatically. Entropy is reduced dramatically. And the arrow of time, therefore, should also slow down. In fact, in the most deepest samadhi, there's no arrow of time. There's no subject-object split. There is only fundamental reality left, which is irreducible and without cause and without form and without fluctuations and without location in space or time. And this is reality which is irreducible, causeless, fundamental, and infinite and timeless and borderless and spaceless. So in deep meditation, when we reach samadhi, the following things occur. The quantum field is basically going to its state of least excitation. The qualia field is also going to its state of least excitation. Metabolic rate is coming down. Entropy is reversing. And the arrow of time is also slowing down. And this is the connection to the quantum body and what we call living a longer, healthier, more vital life. The more we cultivate the qualities of empathy and compassion and generosity and love, the more we reduce the subject-object split. The more we move towards samadhi. And this is actually what yoga is all about. In many of the yogic writings, there's also the concept of bindu. Bindu localized here as the third eye or in front of the third eye. Bindu is a point of almost zero volume, let's say zero volume, and it is the qualia equivalent of singularity. So when we meditate on the bindu, and ultimately even the bindu disappears, then we have arrived in the state of least excitation, least entropy. The arrow of time has slowed. Metabolic rate has slowed down, and self-regulation and homeostasis return to fundamental activity. Fundamental activity as homeostasis is achieved. So samadhi is ultimately the best way to achieve well-being at the level of body, mind, and access the domain of awareness of spirit. And that is the connection between bindu, samadhi, least entropy arrow of time and a longer, healthier, and more joyful life. Let me know your thoughts.